Quickly want to pull out some of the more obvious elements of this story. Academy Award winner, best film, 1931. So let's go over basic story architecture first. This is a good movie, by the way. I enjoyed it. So when you first start writing and filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure via a loop. We identify the classic beginning and ending in a state of perfection, which is lost, becomes a state of imperfection, and the process of returning to it is undergone. You can start there, or you can start there, somewhere in the lost phase. If you do that, then the events there tend to be referenced at later stages, as in this story. Most stories end with some form of state of perfection. If you don't like that term, you can use equal terms, liberation, catharsis, equilibrium, whatever you prefer. If you don't want to end with that, you want to end with imperfection, that's irrelevant. The process is always the same. So you're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, transmogrification, psychological journey. You're always going to have physical journey. And in essence, you're moving through new worlds, which are physical manifestations of new selves, new psychological states, and new worlds, new states in general. On the most simple basic level, you enter a new world or new state, and by the time you exit it, significant change has occurred. But that doesn't mean that the change starts there. It's actually started earlier, and it does continue on. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated. They tell you what tangibles or intangibles you're going in there to acquire, how to construct those sequences. So, for example, if that's the ordinary world, we know it's made up of protection, repression, fear of exit, etc. So those sub-stages show you how to put those major sequences together. The journey itself is a metaphor for a number of things: maturity, awakening, readiness, etc. When you are here, you do not have any of those. You are unable to return and right the wrong. So you have to grow, learn, mature, gain capacities in order to be able to become ready to return. So that is basic story architecture. It's the fundamental framework that all successful stories are based upon, including all Academy Award winning best films. So let's get rid of that and let's draw another loop. So we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle represents. So we're actually starting at the state of imperfection, at the lost phase, because Yancey has already separated. He's already on his own and he's waiting for the land to become available in Oklahoma. So we've got extreme devolution here. In essence, what we have is the inciting incident. So we've got classic prince versus princess, and so Yancey and Dixie Lee, and we pull out a tangible, so that is staking a claim to our piece of land. You can regard that as a minor threshold guardian function, so in essence pulls us into the ordinary world, and then there's the desire to exit it. So Yancey himself wants to leave. There are interdictor functions performed by the mother, repressive mother archetype. Those resistances are overcome, and Yancey leaves that state and pulls out the tangible of his wife and, in essence, family. Once we're out of that state, various functions are performed, for example, limitations, so meeting the kid, but at this point we are not ready to take on the kid and his gang. We go into the new world, in which in essence is the first thresholds of classic border symbolism, riding into the town. We've got new creature sights and sounds, so especially from Sabre's point of view, this is a new dangerous place. And there is the yearning to return to the ordinary state. In other words, there's a resistance to change. At this point, you really cannot go back. There is no return, and the resistance eventually evaporates as transformation sets in, and we see that demonstrated through the loss of Sabra's clothing and her developing a home within the town. We meet our antagonism, and the eventual conquest of that antagonism demonstrates the capacities that capacities are being gained, and also that we are increasingly becoming accepted within the new world, and we are no longer fishes out of water. So when that bad guy is taken out, everybody in the townsfolk say, yep, that's the first thing that should have been done, and Yancey becomes a bit of a hero. physical separation, so now we have our own home and we have a newborn, so we're pulling away from the old state. We basically got a road of trials which forces us to confront our limitations, and that's overcoming the kid, so we shoot the kid. And then further detachment demonstrated by the loss of all new world attachments, so that's the death of Isaiah. All the way round, and really we've got another version of physical separation. So just as there were resistances to it, here there are resistances to it. This time Sabre doesn't want Yancy to leave. Resistances are overcome, and Yancy departs. We have the return. In other words, we're confronting that challenge which could not be conquered there, is conquered here. So that's part of the rebirth. So that is Yancy coming home and ensuring that Dixie Lee doesn't get sentenced. So that demonstrated by a new way of thinking from Sabre's point of view. Atonement really is the arrival of oil, which leads to our apotheosis. So we're really apotheosing out of the earlier state where we were really small town, now to a big booming town, really a big town. And then we've got classic movements, lots of maturity symbolism. So Sabre becomes, in other words, the mother figure, the archetype, the maintainer of the state of perfection. She becomes a congresswoman. The kids have grown up, so we've got maturity symbolism. The town itself has grown up. It's really now become a city. And then we have the departure function, so Yancy's death. So classic, the hero coming in, instigating change, and then leaving. So that is a very basic deconstruction of that story. If you want a detailed deconstruction of it, you can order it off the website. But once again, showing you that all these successful stories follow this pattern of journey, transformation, movement through new worlds and states, the detailed analysis of which you can purchase off our website.